All right, good evening, everyone. My name is Adebanjo Oluwaseyi, and you're welcome to Blast, where believers living and succeeding together. So basically, being the last Thursday of this month, we'll be wrapping up on our theme, Sanctified. And ministering to us this evening is Mr. Wisdom Aserifa. But before the ministration, there was a music ministration by Oluwatosin Kolawole. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of the evening.
Jesus, Savior, my life belongs to you. Master, Redeemer, my life belongs to you. I'm yours, I'm yours. I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours. Lord, I'm yours, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours. Jesus, Savior, my life belongs to you. Master, Redeemer, my life belongs to you. I'm yours, I'm yours. I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours. Lord, I'm yours, I'm yours forever. I'm yours, I'm yours. My life is yours, is yours. My life is yours, is yours forever. Is yours, my life is yours forever. Is yours, my dreams are yours, they're yours, they're yours forever, they're yours, they're yours. My life is yours forever, is yours, is yours. My life is yours forever. Is yours, is yours.
Good evening once again. You're welcome. Hallelujah. It's really a pleasure to have you once again. And I bless the name of the Lord for his faithfulness over our lives. Indeed, we are his and he is ours. It's a privilege. It's really an honor to worship God, because our God is the mighty one, is the Holy One of Israel, is the God of the whole earth. It's a pleasure once again to have you this evening. And we pray that as we go into this session this evening, that your life indeed will be blessed and the Lord will do the work of sanctification in your life once again, and you will be transformed into the image of Christ. But before we go into the word today, we'll be having a worship session again. I know we've sang, but with the house, we'll be singing as a family, representing the ministry and saying that, yes, we belong to God and we are going to stand for God all the days of our lives. We are believers living and succeeding together. So please join us in this little session of worship. I'm sure you'll be blessed. Over to you, Tosin.
Jesus,
that's more.
Jesus, that's more than enough.
For you have joy. My heart
consumed. My heart with your love. You have captured my heart, my heart with your love.
You have
captured
my heart,
consume my heart with your love.
I'll make room for two. Whoa. For you and I, Jesus, you are all that matters. You are all that matters. I'll make room for two. For you and I, Jesus, you are all that matters. You are all that matters. You are all that matters. Hey. Oh, we. Oh, we. Hey.
You are all that matters.
I'll put you in front, say. I'll put you in front, in front of.
In front of my family.
Yeah, you
are. You are all that matters.
Yes, you are, you are.
You are all that matters.
And I'll make room for two.
I'll make room for two.
You and I, Jesus.
Hey, you and I, Jesus.
Hey, you are all that matters. Hey, you are all.
That you will make him your precious gold. You will make him thy treasure. That he becomes your treasure, your only gold and your priority. He becomes more than gold to you. Just as he has you as the apple of his eyes. Just as he has you as the apple of his eyes. That he becomes your treasure. The Bible says, Jesus spoke about someone that when he saw this treasure, when he saw Jesus, when he saw the kingdom of God, he sold all he had. He sold everything just to get this. It is whom we talk about today. It's the kingdom, is our life. It's our God. It's our sanctification. It's our righteousness, our truth. It's the one we seek. It's the one we adore. What a moment. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. I bless you, Lord, you are holy. And forever you are God. I bless you, Lord, you are holy. And forever you are God. And forever you are God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you are God.
Hallelujah, you are God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you are God.
We bless you, Lord, you are holy.
And forever you are God.
Bless you, Lord.
You are holy. And forever you are God.
And forever you are God. We bless
you, Lord. You are holy. Holy, Lord. And forever you are God.
And forever you are Lord.
And you are holy,
holy Lord,
and forever you are God,
and forever you are God.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, you are God,
hallelujah, you are God.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, you are God.
Their depths yet untouched. Their heights yet unreached. Their width yet untouched. Our God is mighty. The best of worship are not in camera. The best of worship, the best of praises are not in camera. But they are on the record of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, where every drop of tears counts before Him. The King of glory, how loving and awesome He is. If we say we can worship Him to the end, even 100 years is not enough to worship this great God. For eternity, we will keep saying, holy, 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 for He is worthy. How awesome is our God. We bless the name of the Lord for how He has been with us. Right from the beginning of this month, July, we started with the team Sanctified. And the Lord has used so many, two great men of God, not so many, but two great men of God, and they have blessed us with the word of God. We had Pastor David, we had Pastor Tony, and Pastor David established the fact that, yes, sanctification is whom we belong to. And don't forget our team, 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19. He said, the foundation of the Lord standeth sure, having the seal, the Lord knoweth them that are His. Let everyone who nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. And that's the text. And that's our call today. In his message, he said something that we should flee. He said, flee all unrighteousness. He said, then pursue righteousness. Flee from youthful lust and pursue righteousness. And I loved Pastor Tony. He came and he reminded us of who we are, the temple of God. And he painted a picture of having the president in our house. I will prepare our house. Then imagine they say that the Lord is coming. How will you prepare your house? How will you prepare your life? So is the mindset behind the team Sanctified. that we will live a life so worthy to the Lord, a life so fitting that the Lord will have us as his dwelling place. But for today, we're looking at the theme, the topic, sanctified and separated. Sanctified and separated. And indeed, the two pastors before today have done justice to this topic, but we'll be re-emphasizing as we round up this theme, sanctify. And I pray that as you join us this evening, the Lord will bless you. Please let us open our Bibles quickly to 2 Timothy chapter 2. Verse 19. Don't forget our topic for today, sanctified and separated. Sanctified and separated. Verse 19 says, which is our theme text, nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having this seal. What is the seal? The Lord knows them that are his. And let everyone who nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Now, we have heard these messages. You may say, yes, I belong to God. You will say, I'm a believer. Yes, I believe in Jesus. But there is a seal. There is a seal. And that seal is that the Lord knoweth them that are his. The Lord knoweth them that are his. Now, can you look at your life and say, God knows me as his own? That's our reflection, even as we begin this new church here of the First Way Gospel Church in Nigeria. Can you say, yes, I have the seal upon my head that I am his, that Jesus is seen upon me, that the seal of the Lord is upon my head? Because I tell you, our Lord is coming soon. And sanctification is not just what you do. It's not how you live your life and say, yeah, I am holy. I don't lie. I don't steal. It is far more than that. It is that you belong to God. It is that you are separated. You are sanctified to God, that you belong to him. But as we study this text, I want us to go before this text and see yourself, and you see the mirror of God's word and look at your own life. Let's go to the preceding verses before this, and we'll start from verse 14. And I'll be doing what the Lord asked me to tell our people today. He said, remind them of these things, charging them before the Lord not to strive about words to no profit, to the ruin of their hearers. Verse 15. Be diligent to present yourself approved unto God, a worker that does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. But shun profane and idle blabbings, for they will increase to more ungodliness, and their message will spread like cancer. Hymenaeus and Philetus are of this sort, who are straight concerning the truth, saying that the resurrection is already past, and they overthrow the faith of some. Saying that the resurrection has already passed, and they overcome the faith of some. Just as you say you are a believer, just as you say you belong to God, the Lord is telling me to admonish you today that you should be diligent to show yourself approved unto God. Unto God. How do you live your life? One thing about sanctification is that, according to Colossians, is that you do all, whatever you do, in words and in deeds. He said, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus. Are you working? Are you in school? Are you at work? You are working in the name of Jesus. Are you in school? You are studying in the name of Jesus. Whatever you do in words and in deeds, do all in the name of Jesus. The Bible is saying that you should show yourself approved unto God. Unto God. Your primary assignment in life is to worship. Is to worship God. It's your sacrifice to God. So the Lord's message to me to you today is that you present yourself. Be diligent to present yourself approved unto God. So you ask yourself, even as we wrap up this theme, sanctify, do you belong to God? Or can God call you his own? The way he described Abraham, can God call you his own? I want you to ponder on it, and so you look at your life and say, yes, I've been living my life. Can God call me his own? Now, what is it that is overthrowing the faith of so many people? So many people are thinking that the resurrection has passed. You may say, yes, I believe that Jesus is coming. But somehow your life may be living and be saying loudly that Jesus is not even coming now. How do I mean? You may not say it with your mouth that, yes, Jesus is not coming. Or the resurrection has passed, as some of them said it. But your life, is it? Are you living a life like Jesus is coming? Are you living a life like a servant expecting his master? Or are you living a life as some who have given up and said, I don't think Jesus is coming? Because if indeed you know that Jesus is coming, and we know and we believe, hallelujah, to many people who we love his appearing, we all rejoice to see Jesus coming in his glory. But I tell you, if you say you believe, how are you preparing? Are you ready for your master? Are you ready for your God? Are you expecting his return? Because the Bible says that you depart from iniquity. If you're expecting his return and you know the hope of his calling, you will know that at the end we'll be like him. We'll rejoice like him. We'll be when we see his face. According to 2 John. Whoa, ho, ho. It's going to be glorious. When we see the face of our Lord Jesus, that we'll behold him and we'll know that he's facing us face to face, and we say, this is Jesus and this is you. And there is a crown of resurrection. There's a crown of glory for those people. Crown of righteousness for as many that love is appearing. But the Bible says, if you know indeed that you are expecting him, he said you will keep yourself just as he's pure. You will keep yourself just as he's pure. And today, your God, my God, is sending me to you. Using the word in 2 Corinthians chapter 6. What relationship has darkness with light? What relationship do they have? How are you living your life? Are you lost in the world? Can they see Jesus in you? Because there's a seal upon their head. I want us to go into the next month having the seal upon our head that Jesus is my seal. Jesus is my life. That others will see Jesus in you, that they will know. And they will behold his glory in your life. That is how you are sanctified unto God. And now there is the call for separation. Our Father is telling you today, you and I, he said, come out from among them and be separated, that I may receive you. Oh, God. Come out from among them. You are in this world, but you are not of this world. You are in this world, but you are not of this world. You are in this world, you are not of this world. I will keep emphasizing it by the grace of God. That it will sink in our heart, in our soul, and be transformed. That yes, we belong to God. Because indeed, when the Savior will come, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 25, from verse 31, he said, the Son of Man will come and he will separate the goat from the sheep. He's going to separate the goat from the sheep. And to the sheep, he will say, come to my right hand. But to the goats, now you ask yourself, am I separated unto the Lord? And I'm sending his word to you today. Come out from among them and be separated. Say to your Lord, my Lord, and I will receive you. You will be to me my sons and daughters. God loves you. God does not want you to perish. I don't want you also to be on that last day. I don't want any of us to be on that last day saying, Jesus, we prophesied in your name. We did so many things in your name. Guess what he will say? I know you not. I know you not. It's not that he's even saying that, but we did this in your name. Sir, God, we prophesied in your name. We casted out demons in your name. We did so many things in your name. We went to church in your name. But there is a need for separation to the will of perfect God, perfect will of God. Even as you belong to God, there's a place of separation. He said, touch no unclean thing, then I will receive you. Touch no unclean thing, then I will receive you. And you will be to me my sons and daughters. Are you a child of God and you are hearing me today as we round up? Are you a child of God? Are you a believer? You say you believe in Jesus. Are you indeed sanctified and separated? These two words, these two topics, or these two words in these topics, rather, is equal to consecration. When you are sanctified and separated to Him, these two words is equal to consecration. And what is consecration? That you are in the perfect will of God. That you deny yourself of whatever pleasure. And you take up your cross daily and follow Him. I'll be wicked as a leader if I will not remind you of those things, because the wrath of God is coming upon those who are the goats, upon those ones who are not following the will of God. You can say, yes, I am separated. I am sanctified. I am sanctified to God. Yes, you are sanctified. But are you departing from iniquity? You can say, yes, I am separated. But are you keeping yourself sanctified? So these two must go hand in hand. The Bible said, Jesus said in his word, he said, except them that do the perfect will of the Father. Matthew 7. He said, not everyone who said to me, Lord, Lord, we come, we enter into the kingdom of heaven. But as many that do the perfect will, the perfect will, the perfect will of the Father. The Father who has called us into holiness. He has called us into perfection. And as He's pruning us with His word every day, washing us till we are without spot or wrinkle, I want you to yield, not just being sanctified and saying, yes, you belong to Jesus, but that you also be separated and touch no unclean thing. And He will receive you. And you will be to Him His son and His daughter. And I pray that at the end, we will not be ashamed. That we will continually live in His fire, being sanctified. That at His appearing, we will be like Him, glorious in beauty. That when we see Him, we will be like Him. I don't know if you love this. If you love His appearing, this is His word to you today. Kapali Natosh. Ketelema. I wish anyone has a song. Kapaya. Maseleta.
When I love this ever before me,
Kapali Natosh.
He seals upon my heart.
Janatele.
I live for the one I love.
Olate lanama.
The one I love. Kaselete. Is ever before
Malananeta
me.
Sanama.
He seals upon my heart.
Oh God.
I live for the one I love.
Do you live your life for the one you love? Or are you living for yourself? My people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of waters. And they have hewed for themselves cisterns, broken cisterns that hold no water. I call you today, come. Come, come, come. How far have you gone from your Lord? Are you in His perfect will? Do you live your life for him every day? Is Jesus seen upon you? You cannot fake it. If Jesus is upon you, it will be obvious. You may be persecuted for it, but the end is glory. The end is glory. Here's the comfort, that the end is glory. That the end is glory. I do not know what you are passing through now, but hold on. Hold on to Jesus. That you have yourself sanctified to him. Consecrated to this perfect will. That you live all your life. I don't know if you can join me in this song. It says, all to Jesus I surrender, all to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust in me, in his presence daily. I surrender to you, Jesus. I surrender to you. All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender.
Surrender unto him I freely give. I will ever love and trust in him, his presence daily. I surrender
to you, Jesus.
I surrender.
I surrender. Oh,
all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender.
Jesus said, no man having put his hand in the plow, looking back his feet for the kingdom of God. Have you put your hand in the plow and you're looking back? Have you really surrendered all? If indeed you have surrendered all, that you live your life all to him. All. What is it that is holding you back? The rich man. When Jesus said, go and sell all your goods, he was sober and he left. In the Bible, we never heard of him again. We never heard of him again. That you surrender all to him. That you live your life totally for him.
Withholding nothing. I surrender to you. Everything I
Jesus,
give.
We thank you.
To you.
Jesus, we thank you.
Withholding nothing.
Listen. As you listen to this song, are you there? Are you out there? And I want you to focus on me now. Just focus on your screen, or if you are listening to me through the radio, please just stay calm and listen, please. You are there. You've never accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. There is grace for you now and today that you accept him as your Lord and Savior and be saved. The Bible said, as many that believe in him, to them he gave right to be called the sons of God. What manner of love has the Lord bestowed upon us that we should be called his children? What he's saying to you, that you believe in Jesus. That you believe in Jesus. So I call you today to believe in Jesus. And if you indeed want to give your life to Christ, you can reach us with our contacts. Or you can search for us on Facebook, 4SQ Blast. 4SQ Blast. I'll be so glad to pray with you and to counsel you. But just say these words with me. Say, Lord Jesus, please forgive me. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I believe that you are Jesus, the Son of God. I believe in you. Please, Jesus, keep me your righteousness. I believe in you. I receive eternal life. Help me to live from today. From today, O Lord, for you alone. Help me, O Lord, in Jesus' name. I congratulate as many of you who have made this decision. I congratulate you. But there is a resolve in your heart, and the Holy Spirit will oil your heart with such grace that you will serve the Lord with all your heart. Now, to those who have, you know that you have derailed, you know that you have left the Lord, you know that it's been long you really serve the Lord, it's been long you worship. As I said, even as we started, that the best of worship are not on these cameras. The best of worship are in the secret place, where each tears and each sweat are counted, where the relationship heightens and flourish. Oh, that he will call you his own and you will call him your own. Are you longing for such relationship again? I want you to take this prayer with me, please. And say, Father, please forgive me, Lord. You have called us to come out, and I'm coming out to you. Please, Lord, receive me. Help me not to touch, and no unclean thing, O Lord. May I not touch anything unclean. Receive me again, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. I want you to keep praying like that. Just keep praying. The Father, just like the prodigal son, is longing for you. And I know he's going to embrace you with such a hug that you will know that you are in the arm of the Father. Thank you so much for joining us. You could hang in and worship. The Lord bless you.
No, you keep down, lie down, coming after me. No shadow you will light up, mountains you will climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. No shadow, no shadow, no shadow you won't light up, mountains you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down.
No wall you won't kick down.
Lie
you won't tear down.
Coming
after me.
No shadow.
No shadow you won't light up.
Mountains
you won't climb up.
Coming
after me.
No walls.
No wall you won't kick down. Lie you won't tear down.
Coming after me.
Thank you so much. We are believers living and succeeding together. It's always a pleasure to have you. And I pray that as you continue with us, the Lord will bless you. Happy new month in advance. See you next month. God bless you. Don't forget to follow us on our social media page.
Facebook, Twitter, Instagram @4SQBlast.